interview with both of them.
One of the big stories in Queens County this week has been Kenra Schott's problem with the region over her house flooding and the possibility that if this doesn't get resolved, Kenra will lose her insurance and possibly can lose her house. I'm speaking with Kenra in her kitchen today. Good morning, Kenra. How are you?
I've been better, Dan.
Yeah, I can imagine you have. Would you like to briefly just tell us how this whole situation has come to be?
Well, if we stem back to October, my first flood was in October, the 17th to be exact. At that point, I did have one region works department member in my kitchen, which I told him that the makeshift gate that was shoved down in the brook to stop debris from blocking it needed to be rectified, needed to be taken out, and that opening, everything needed to be fixed. That was directly from my insurance company. On the night of March the 30th, my oldest son arrived upstairs a quarter after 11 and frantic, seeing that there was water in the basement. At that point, it was already 3 inches up over my laminate floor. The whole basement was completely renovated. My daycare, my son's room, everything in the whole entire basement's been destroyed.
And how did the region react? I presume you called the region at some point fairly closely after that. And what kind of reaction did you get from them?
Monday morning, as soon as the region opened, I called and left a message for Brad Roeder. He did return my phone call. At that point, I advised him what would take place here in October. At that point, he said that he had no idea I had a flood in October. He said he would get the insurance company to get in contact with me, their insurance company. At that point, I had heard nothing up until Wednesday. 2:10 that day, the gate was removed and has not been back. That stood in the ditch for 8 to 9 years.
And did you contact your counselor, Bruce Inglis?
Yes, I did. The night that it happened, actually, Mom called the house as the flooding was taking place, and the next morning as well. Bruce has sent me a Facebook message stating who I was to contact, Brad Roeder, which I did.
And I understand you've also had some contact with the mayor, Christopher Clark, and what's his reaction to all this?
Well, I waited 3 weeks for a return phone call from Mr. Clark. Last Tuesday, I picked up the phone again and called the region. He did return my phone call, which he left a message on my phone stating that it was in the insurance hands and he could not make comment. But he wasn't telling me not to call him back, but if I did call back, that he couldn't make comment on anything.
I heard that message, Kendra. You passed it on to your mom and dad, and I was at their house, and I did hear that message. And do you feel that's the way that you should, as a taxpayer, be treated?
Absolutely not, and I am willing to let anybody listen to that message. It's disheartening to understand for myself why somebody could not come to my door and sit down and talk to me or discuss any matter. Yesterday, there was an email sent to Alex J. Walling from the mayor stating that 3 staff members, as well as an adjuster, have been to my house to speak to me. I want the 3 names of the staff members that have been here, the times, the dates, and the discussions. I'm telling you, right now, not one person has stepped foot on my property, nor Gene Legg's property. We've had no communication. We've tried communication. There's not willing to talk. I understand counselors can't talk. Bruce and Susan McLeod have been great. They were both here. Bruce was here for over 2 hours last night to get a really good feel for what's going on. He walked the land behind me that's owned by the region. He sees where the water's coming down. The grounds are eroded. There's trees up there standing on root balls because there's no mud under them. My grounds are totally saturated. The water tables are so high here that it has no place to escape. It's been going on for over 10 years. I talked to the man who bought the purchase of this property from the region. He said the agreement was they were to put the road in and maintain that ditch. That's when he purchased. That was over 10 years ago.
And today, what's the status of it? What's going on? Are you still waiting for answers?
I'm
getting ready to have your basement fixed, or...
right as this moment, as Mr. Clark knows, it is not in any lawyer's hands. We have a lawyer that's willing to represent us, as well as a drainage expert from the Supreme Court of Canada to come do a drainage survey here. I shouldn't have to go to that extreme. I shouldn't have to prove their inadequacy of their own issues. And right now, it's all that I can tell you is of February 21st, 2015, if this is not proven and they do not take responsibility and get it fixed, I cannot put one stick of wood back in my basement. My son has to remain living with my parents. My business is completely destroyed. I have to carry massive insurance when it comes to daycares. I will not have a reputable insurance company. I'll be paying through the nose, literally $4,000 or more a year for insurance. I'll never be able to sell my house. At this point, I don't even want to reside in this town. You feel like an outsider when you have your own mayor lying. And I will prove that he is lying. And I want the names of the people that he stated in that email. You don't treat residents like this.
And I understand that you pay substantial taxes here because you run a daycare center.
Over $4,000.
That is...
Commercial, I might add. 30% of my house is rezoned commercial.
Well, that to me is a substantial amount of taxes in Queens County. I don't care where you live in Queens County, and maybe other than out on White Point Resort or the big house in Somerville, but that's a lot of money to be paying in taxes.
Which I don't mind, because you know what? I grew up here. I decided to come back here. My family is here. Right now, between all of us, it's taken a toll on us, put it that way.
Okay, well, thank you for talking with us, Kendra. And all we can do as QCCR is we're going to put your story on the air, and we're going to make sure that we do follow-up with you to see that hopefully we can help you get this resolved. I know Mr. Walling from Pulse of Queens County is on side with you, and Beverly Ware from the Chronicle Herald is involved with this, so we're going to do whatever we can as the media to help you and to help your neighbor, Mrs. Legg, get this matter resolved. And I mean, I know there's all kinds of pictures and...
We have over 100 pictures and video. I have documented this since the last flood to prove that this is not looked after. It goes for a week at a time. Even when we had the flood, it took them 5 days to come clean it out. The first flood. This flood that I had last time in March, they were here at 8:20 in the morning removing it as I stood there and took pictures. Three people stood in the ditch.
If we had another storm like we had the end of March today, would your basement flood again?
1,000%. When there's I call it the perfect storm. If we have storm surge, heavy rains, and a high tide, this ditch floods. The water cannot escape a 36-inch pipe on the ocean side. It needs a rocked-in area, a holding tank, more or less, on the municipality's land, which they own below me, that they purchased to put piping from this ditch the whole way down to the ocean side. But as we know, the town of Liverpool loves to flood every time that it rains. There's no control over that unless you have some sort of holding area for the water to be dispersed.
All right, well, we've been talking today with Kendra Schott. She lives on Lawrence Street over just by the fire hall, and she's got a major drainage problem on her property, her neighbor's property. And looking out her back window right now, I can see that there's almost, you could call it a forest out there, and I would presume there's a lot of low land, and that's probably one of the things that's contributing to this. Kendra, thanks for talking with us, and I will keep in touch.
Thank you.
You may have heard from the tone of that interview that, understandably, Kendra Schott is very upset. Next, we spoke with Jean Legg, who lives next door at 27 Lawrence Street, and here's what she had to say. We're over again on Lawrence Street today, talking to Jean Legg, who lives at 27 Lawrence Street. Jean, I understand you've had a flooding problem here, the same as Kendra Schott has.
Yes.
Would you like to tell us a little bit about what happened at your house?
Well, it was a scary night. Kendra's son came over and said, "Have you got any water in your basement?" And I said, "Well, I don't know." And I went and looked, and it was a foot and a half of water down there, and everything was floating. and it was a scary thing.
Now, did you lose some possessions that were down here?
Yes.
Thrown away?
Yes, and the first thing they had to do was come and fix the furnace. And then they come and put a new hot water tank in because that had to go. And I tried to dry out a lot of things that I thought I could save. And a lot of things just had to go out because everything was soaked. And it took about a week and a half to dry things out. And they took the gyprock and insulation off the walls and dried it all out, so they haven't come back yet to replace that, but they will do that and take out a few more things that the insurance adjuster said had to go.
How did you get in contact with the mayor or the council, and what was their reaction to this?
Well, I didn't, because Kendra was dealing with them, and I thought that would be okay. But I guess I should have approached these people too, but apparently they're not doing anything anyway. But
are you confident that if you had your basement repaired today that the flood wouldn't happen again?
Oh, I'd be, every time it rains, I worry about it.
Is this the first time it happened, or did this happen to you in the past before?
Well, it just happened to me once since I'm living here, but I understand it has happened before I came here.
How long have you been here?
It'll be 4 years in August.
Okay, and then are you satisfied with what the region's doing, or?
No, definitely not. No.
I know Kendra's understandably very upset. She feels that her business is being destroyed.
Absolutely, it is. And this is very stressful for both of us.
And is the region giving you, or anybody from the region, giving you any optimistic hope that this problem is going to get resolved?
No.
So, folks, the same thing is happening to Mrs. Legg, is happening to Kendra Schott, that her property is undergone an awful lot of damage, and it has to be repaired. And it seems that the region is unwilling, or just plain doesn't want to do anything. And Jean, thank you for talking with me. We're going to, I told Kendra we're going to follow up with her, and we're going to join the other media like the Chronicle Herald and the Pulse of Wayne County, and we're going to try with what little maybe influence we have in this town to get a resolve on this.
Well, I hope something good will come out of this.
Well, thank you for talking with me.
You're welcome, sir.